Did you know adding a mirror to your interior gives the illusion of a larger space than it actually is? Stick till the end of this video and I'll share invaluable interior designing tricks and tips so you can design interiors like a pro. But before we do that, we actually have to model the room, add materials, do lighting and add furniture. So let's get started. Modeling the room is the easiest. Default cube is all you need. Press G and then Z to move your cube on the Z axis. Go to the edit mode, select the top face and move it along the Z axis up to a height you prefer. Scale it on the X and Y axis as you like. You can copy my exact dimensions if you like. Now hit number pad 0 to go to the camera view. So let me adjust my camera angle. Go to the plan view by hitting number pad 7. Place the camera inside the room. Now move your camera down until you are in the room and you have a good camera height. Move your camera backward as possible so you have a good view. Increasing your room length just to make your camera view bigger makes your room unrealistic. Instead, you can change the focal length of your camera. Later, you can change it if your renders are too distorted. However, I'll increase the width of the room a bit. Next step is adding a window to the room. To do that, add these loop cuts. Go to the face select mode and select these faces. Extrude them like this and delete these faces. Add another loop cut in the middle like this. Go to the right side view and add another loop cut. Select these two faces and extrude them. This is for modeling the wardrobe. Now add two loop cuts in this direction. Scale them along the x-axis a bit. Position them towards the middle. Select this face and extrude it away. Add two loop cuts in between and two more like this. Move those two loop cuts towards the previous loop cuts like so. Select these two faces and extrude away. I'm going to create the wardrobe from this cube itself, but I'll fast forward the process. You can slow down if you want to know the exact steps. It only involves duplicating and extruding. I'm using rail windows from Archimesh add-on to add doors to this wardrobe. I'll change the dimensions of the windows in the Create menu. I only need these panels, so let me delete the rest of the windows. I need three panels, so I'll duplicate this. Now I'll add a rail window here too. However, this whole window will be covered by the curtains which I will add later, so you don't have to worry too much about this window. Next, I'll add a cupboard between the wardrobe and this wall. Select this face and duplicate it. Move it down and extrude. Position it appropriately like so. Move the whole thing down, duplicate it few times and create the cupboard. To add materials, I'll shift to shader editor. I'll adjust the windows like this. Go to the edit mode with the cube selected. In the X-ray mode, select the floor like this. I'm using EasyPBR add-on. First, you have to load the library. I'll add the wood flooring. I'm using this wood floor 039 if you want to be exactly same as mine. Go to material properties, hit this plus icon in the add-on. Click OK. Select the new material and press assign. You might have to download this material if you're using this material for the first time. It comes with a mapping node, so I can increase the scale also a bit if I want to. In the edit mode, hit A to select all the faces and press U. Select Smart UV Project to unwrap the cube. There's one little problem you might not notice. Your faces are flipped right now. To fix that, go to Viewport Overlays. Check this box next to Face Orientation. We want to change the red color to blue. You can hit Alt N. Click on Flip. You can uncheck Face Orientation afterwards. This color of the floor is too washed out for my liking, so I'll add a hue saturation node and then reduce saturation and value to make it a bit darker. The next step is adding materials to the wall. So first I'll add a new material. Change the color like so, you can differentiate this new material. With the required faces selected, hit assign. Hit Shift A and choose image texture. I'm using this black and white texture of a cloth. Hit Ctrl A and apply the scale. Go to edit mode, hit U and select Smart UV Project. I have used this mix node to mix two variations of this RGB color according to the black and white texture I have added. and this method is to improve the intensity of the texture. Here is my final node setup for the wall material. You can copy it if you wish. Actually, I am using this material for this middle part of the wall, and I'll use a darker version of the same material to the rest of the walls. Now the basics are done. The next step is adding furniture and other assets. I have used various asset libraries like 3dsky.com and 3D Warehouse. They are not blend files, so I have to import them. To do that, go to File, Import, select the file type, locate and select the downloaded file. Sometimes you might have to do some changes to the asset and load the textures as well. Then I'll add curtains. I'll scale it to fit my window. These are the materials that I have used for my curtains. You can copy the node setup if you want. My workflow is cycles. Therefore, let me change the render engine to cycles. I'll reduce the maximum samples in both viewport and render. I enable the denoising as well. The next bit is lighting. Lighting this scene is pretty easy. I'm using an HDRI. Go to World Properties. Click on this yellow dot and choose an environment texture. Click open and choose an HDRI you like. I'm using this Misty Pines HDRI, which I have downloaded from polyheaven.com. Increase the strength up to 10. I'm rendering only the camera view. Therefore, I'll select the region by pressing Ctrl B. Let's see how this look now. So I see few issues. I need to add the material for the wardrobe. This wood 017 is ideal for this, but it is too light colored for my liking. So I'll change its value in the hue saturation node. Basic scaling and rotation of the UV map is also required. I gave window frames a simple color and I changed the glass material of this third window panel to a wood texture. I added a rug as well as a plant to the scene. I'm making a simple nightstand from my default cube itself. I have added a mirror and placed it here. Then a flower vase, a table lamp and two books on the nightstand. This is my interior up to this point. The wardrobe looks weird. One reason, it is open from the back. So let me fix that. This nightstand and the cupboard require some material as well. For that, I'll use this marble texture. However, I have to unwrap this. These extra assets are needed to make the wardrobe realistic. Next up is adding panel lights. The base of these light fixtures should go into the ceiling. I'll have to extrude two holes for that. I'll speed up the process. You can slow it down if you want to see the exact steps. It seems like this wardrobe material is too saturated. Let me reduce the saturation and reduce the value too. Same goes for this pot as well. I added a second plant to the bedroom. At this point, I'm really satisfied with my interior, but I think we can do better. In fact, I can improve the look by just a single click. Go to Render Properties, scroll down, click on Color Management. On default, View Transform should be Filmic, so if you are on Standard, change it to Filmic. And change the look to High Contrast or Very High Contrast. Look at that! Your scene looks better now, isn't it? Next up is modeling the ceiling. I'm just going to select the top faces, Inset, extrude them down a bit. But my ceiling looks a bit messy. I have to get rid of extra edges and extrusion for the panel lights. Select these faces, hit I to inset. Move these edges towards the wardrobe and these edges away from the curtains like so. Now hit E to extrude the ceiling down. Let's go to the rendered view. Yeah, it looks better now. Now to complete the room, I need a table and a chair. The usual height of a table is just between someone's waist and their knees. I added this model of a man to figure out the height of the table. I'll speed up the process. Next is adding a chair. I'll add a few books and a table lamp too. Up until now, we had only one camera view, and it does not catch our new table and the chair. So select the camera, press I, and select location and rotation, which adds a keyframe. Now press the right arrow key once to move forward by a single frame. Get into a view that you prefer and press Ctrl, Alt and number pad 0. Now you can select the camera and make any changes to your view. It feels kinda empty. So let me reduce the length of this room like this. Now that's better. These curtains look black. I'll reduce the darkness a little bit. This table too needs some materials. I'm using the wood texture that I used for the wardrobe. I just added another keyframe for my camera. I want to add a light between the ceiling and the wall. I tried adding a new material with an emission value, but it didn't work. It looked terrible. So I added area lamps instead and it worked perfectly, and changed the table lamp also. That's it, we did it. So this is my render. I added an ottoman also. Now I'll share some of the tricks that I used to make this interior interesting. First, I had a specific person in my mind when I'm designing this interior. Actually, this is for a young couple. When you have an intended user for the room, it is easier to add assets and furniture. There is a lesser tendency for you to make mistakes. And the other thing is, you need to have some background for the people who are going to use this room. For example, what are they going to do inside the room? What are their likes? What are their dislikes? This young couple likes to read and one of them is working from home. So that explains the table and the chair. You see, all the furniture added has a relation with the people who are going to live here. If you get that right, your interior is halfway done. I have only used cozy and relaxing colors throughout the room. No too bright and saturated colors. Colors like beige and shades of gray will give you a calm and comfortable feeling. I have used a vibrant purple color for the curtains and for the blanket on the bed. Having some vibrancy is too needed, otherwise your room may just look dull, and it balances the colors as well. There are few other additions that makes this room visually appealing. A mirror is one. It is stylish and makes the space appear larger than it truly is. Curtains add elegance and a fresh look. And curtains enhance the comfy feeling. An ottoman and soft pillows too enhances the comfort. Plants can bring great energy into the room. It enhances the health and provide a calm feeling. Stylish walls, panel lights and ambient lighting around the ceiling gives the modern look I intend to have. I enhance the visual appearance of the room by adding elements in such a way that it has a visual balance. For example, this room has few too many straight lines in the walls, wardrobe and in the ceiling. However, the bed, pillows, curtains and the ottoman balances that with their rounded edges. I hope you get the gist of it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Give this video a thumbs up so people passionate about interior designing like you can find this. If you want to create stunning interiors like this, press that subscribe button. See you in the next video.